Welcome to this Yin Yoga class for beginners. This class is designed to help improve your sleep. So it is a Yin class, however it is more on the restorative side. So you will need a couple of props, and I've just got a couple of pillows from my bed and also a couple of blocks. However, if you haven't got yoga blocks, you can use a couple of books or even some blankets can do, or even the pillows as well. So if you just want to grab those and put them to one side for now. And when you're ready, we'll start in a seated position. So any comfortable seated position for you. And we'll bring our hands to our knees. And we'll start by just taking a few slow, deep breaths in. Inhaling through the nose, feel the belly expand. And exhale out the nose. We'll do that two more times. So inhale, exhale. Last time, inhale, exhale. And just let your breath return to its natural rhythm. And we'll start in a pose called butterfly pose. So if you just want to bring the soles of your feet together, and you can have them as far out as you like. It might be comfortable to have them about two hand prints apart. Or if that's not comfortable for you, you can have them in a little bit closer as well. And then while we're here, we have a few options to use our props. So if you've got a couple of blocks and you've got quite a lot of space under the knees like I do, you might want to put them just under the legs to give them a little bit of extra support. The other option, you can do both if you like, is to just grab your pillows and you can just put them up in front of you. And then either you can stay here with a nice straight back, or you can start to just roll forward, just letting the arms hang, bringing the head down to the pillow or towards the knees. You might just want to play around, try one pillow, maybe try two pillows, see what's good for you. We will be holding this pose for about 3 minutes, so just make sure you're nice and comfortable in this pose, and you may at some point just play around with the props as well. I'll let you know once we get halfway through. So if you did feel like you're deepening into the pose and you wanted to maybe change a couple of props around, you'll have that opportunity. And while you're here, it's important just to notice whether you do feel any pain. Yoga shouldn't be painful. You want to feel a little bit of a stretch, but definitely no pain. Maybe just bring in your awareness to your breath. Noticing whether you hold any tension in the jaw or the mouth or the neck. Just see whether you can notice that and let it go. You're about halfway through this pose now. Maybe noticing whether you're wanting to change any of the props you're using. If you're just happy where you are today. Remember not to force yourself. You just want to kind of melt into the poses.
We'll just be here for another 3 rounds of breath. Just doing so very slowly, just rolling up, bringing the head up last,
removing any props, you can just place them to one side for now, and supporting the legs to come up to center, bring the hands out behind you, and just window wiper the legs really slowly, side to side. Next we'll be taking a pose called deer pose. So easiest to go back into our butterfly pose. And then from here, just take your right leg and bring it out behind you. The left leg can stay parallel to the front of the mat. You can play around with the legs here. So if you feel any discomfort, maybe in the hips or anything, feel free to just adjust the legs to see what feels good for you. Maybe bring in the sole of the foot in towards the hip or the butt of the bum a little bit more, bring it out slightly. Same with the front leg, you can bring that one in a bit more as well. And then we'll take our pillows and we'll just place them to the outside of the left hip. Again, you're going to adjust where you want the pillows exactly in this pose once you get into it. It is a little bit of a twist, so just notice how it makes your back feel and feel free to change the angle if you need to as well. So we'll start by just rotating from the waist, bringing the torso so it's in line with your pillows, and then just bring the torso down towards the mat. The head can either be facing the left or the right, whatever feels good for the neck. If you are facing the left, then you're getting a little bit more of a twist in the spine. So only do that if it feels okay for the neck. And again, we'll be here for about 3 minutes. So just make sure you get nice and comfortable in this pose. Readjusting the legs or even the pillows if you need to. And I'll let you know once we're halfway through, just in case you want to switch direction of the head or just make any little changes. This does feel at all too much for the back, then feel free to bring the pillows maybe in front and just fold down here. Even just fold the pillows in half to give you a bit more room. We're about halfway through the pose now. If you can maintain those
gentle breaths. Just hold it for 3 more rounds of breath. And when you're ready to come out of the pose, just use the arms again, slowly just making your way back up, and the head up last, moving the props out the way, and we'll just bring our legs around in front, arms behind, and again we'll just take a couple of rows of the hips, window wiper, the legs side to side. Just take in any movements that you feel like you need. And we'll take that on the opposite side. So just moving this time with the left leg out towards the left, right leg in front. Play around with the position of the legs. Notice how it feels in the knee. You can always put some extra padding under the knee or the left bum cheek if you feel like you need to. And then taking your pillows, bring them out to the right, outside of the right hip, so to the side, just move it out so you can see. And then rotating from the belly, just start to move your torso around. So you're facing the pillows, and then you can just bring your torso down slowly. Resting your head either to the left or to the right. Maybe noticing whether this side feels slightly different to the other side. And we'll be here for about 3 minutes. Recognizing whether you feel any tension in the body. And if you do, just see if you can direct your breath there. You're about halfway through the pose now. Just noticing whether you want to make any adjustments. Maybe changing the direction of the head if that feels okay for the neck. you do feel like this is too low for you, you can use as many, many pillows as you like. There's no limit. I suppose the limit would be the number of pillows you have, but feel free to use as many as you have. Just three more rounds of breath here. And then slowly start to walk the hands up, supporting the body coming up nice and slow. Just give yourself enough time to readjust. Moving the props out the way, bringing the hands behind you. And gently we'll just rock the legs side to side. Can be as generous as you like with these rocks. You can bring the legs all the way over to the floor. Release tension in the back. Great. Then come up to a seated position. So we'll be taking the caterpillar pose next. So again, have a few options with the props. You can either use your blocks if you like. We do want to keep a little bit of a bend in the backs of the knees, and depending on how tight your hamstrings are, you might like to have something to support you. So that might just be rolling up the mat a couple of times to give you a little bit of support under the knees. Or you can use a couple of blocks or books to support the knees. Another option is to use a pillow just to give you a bit more height there. You also have the option to maybe sit on a pillow. I'm giving you a lot of different options here, so just play around with it and take the one that feels good for you. So this might be where you are today. And then we'll just inhale. And exhale, just fold forward, just letting the hands with the palms facing up, just next to the legs resting here. So you may have done this pose in vinyasa or hatha yoga before, and in those poses they're a lot more active, which means that you are really pushing into the pose. But in yin, we don't want to be active. They are passive poses, and that means the pose won't look the same as what it might look for you in a hatha yoga class or a different type of yoga class. And that's perfectly fine. We're targeting different tissues in the body. So just recognizing that. Just want to melt into the pose, maybe relaxing the head down and the neck down. If you prefer as well, you can always use a pillow in front of the torso, resting the arms on it and folding forward that way as well. Be here for about another 3 minutes, so just get nice and comfortable. Maybe try a few different props to support you. I'll let you know when we're halfway into the pose, and at that point you might like to just maybe move a couple of props and just see if you can melt any further into the pose. Thank you. halfway through, feel free to make any adjustments that you might like to take. Any adjustments that you do take, just make sure you do them slowly so you're not going to counteract any of the work that we've done so far. Just be here for three more rounds of breath. Slowly, when you're ready, just start to walk the hands up, roll up very slowly, and the head up last, moving any props that you might be using out of the way. And just bring the soles of the feet on the floor again, arms out behind, just again, window wipe, put the legs side to side. These gentle twists are really great counterposes to any forward folds that we do. So we'll be making our way down onto the floor now. Just make sure you've got a couple of props next to you. I'm going to give you two options for this next pose. So this is supported fish. So the first option is to bring your pillows down behind you, and you want to bring them so they're up against your tailbone or your back. And then you can have the feet, either soles of the feet on the floor, or you can have the legs out long, whatever feels best for you. And then just start to fold back over the pillows. Bring the arms out to the side, the palms are facing up. This is our first option for our supported fish pose. And again, you can use as many pillows as you like here. We're just getting a gentle opening over the front body and a release through the upper back and the spine. So this is the first option that you can take. Otherwise, if you've got a couple of yoga blocks, you can also use some books. Just make sure that they're nice and strong books for this one. And the other option is just to place your blocks behind you, one lengthways and one parallel with the mat. And then the same as what we've done with the pillows, we'll just start to fold down onto the blocks. You will need to readjust them as you get there. So one is to support the head, and the other, the back. And again, we just bring the arms out to the side. So this one is just a bit more of an intense chest opening. So if you are quite tense through the upper back, then this one might be a little bit too much for you, but you can try them both out, see which one you prefer. And again, we'll be here for about 3 minutes. So just make sure you're nice and comfortable in the pose. You do want to feel a little bit of a stretch, but definitely no pain.
breathing into the belly, feeling the belly expand. On the inhale and soften on the exhale. Halfway through this pose now. Notice how the body feels now to when you first came into this pose. Noticing whether you've got any tension in the body, whether you have any tension in the jaw. Notice that and see if you can release a little bit. Maybe stretching out the mouth wide. Maybe yawning. I'm going to just take 3 more deep breaths here. Come out of this one nice and slowly, but just bringing the soles of the feet to the floor if they're not there already. And just rolling over to one side really gently, removing any props that you're using, just placing them to one side. And then we'll just roll back down onto the floor. And we'll just take a moment here. You can leave the soles of the feet on the floor if you like, but you can send the legs out long. We just want to bring some awareness to how our body feels. You might feel like you're melting into the floor. We've got one final pose before we move into our final resting pose, and that pose is supported bridge. So again, you have the option to either use your block or book, or you can use your pillow, and I'll show you how you can use both. So you'll be bringing the soles of the feet to the floor if they're not there already, just taking your props, however many you would like to use. And then pushing into the feet, just lifting the hips up and placing your props under the sacrum. So we want the hips and the sacrum supported here. Just make sure that the lower back feels okay. And arms come out to the side, palms can face up. Or if you like, you can even rest the hands just on the belly and bring the attention back to the breath. Notice whether you are crunching the neck at all, so you do want to have about the size of an apple distance between your chin and your chest here. And you can stay here if you like, you can always send the legs out long. This stretch will just get a bit more into the hips. Just notice how that feels for the lower back. If it gets too much, then you can bring the soles of the feet back to the floor. So that's the first option, using pillows. Otherwise, if you prefer, you can also use a brick. And you've got three settings to choose from. And whichever setting you choose, you just want to place it under the sacrum. So make sure that it's not on the lower back, so it's just below the underwear line. And again, the hands can just come down to the side, palms facing up, or maybe resting the hands on the belly. You can keep the soles of the floor, of the feet on the floor. You can bring the legs out long here. Just play around with it a little bit. We'll be here for another 3 minutes. And I'll let you know when you're halfway. Noticing how the breath arrives into the belly, and just notice how it leaves. So you're about halfway through this pose now. You can stay here if you like, or if you would like, you can take waterfall pose by just lifting one leg and then the other leg, so the soles of the feet are up towards the ceiling. This is just an option that at any point you do want to bring the feet back down to the floor, that's perfectly fine. Both these options are inversion, so they're really restorative poses. And if you are next to a wall at all, if you prefer, you can just rest your legs up against the wall for support. And just continue to breathe into the belly. Those deep, slow breaths. And we'll just stay here for three more rounds of breath. When you're ready, just slowly coming out of the pose, pushing into the feet, pushing the hips up, gently removing whatever props you're using, and then just slowly roll the spine back down onto the floor. You can bring the knees in towards the chest if you like, maybe just gently rocking side to side. We'll bring the hands to the tops of the knees and taking a few circles in one direction and the other direction. And from here we'll move into our final resting pose, which is our corpse pose. And again, there's a couple of options for this. So the first option is just to send your legs out long, palms facing up. Whether if you feel any pain in the lower back at all, any discomfort, or if you just prefer, you can place your pillows, one or two, just under the knees, a little bit of extra support. And we'll be here for about 3 minutes. We'll us bring our attention back to the breath. These deep belly breaths are quite restorative and calming for the nervous system. Just take in that last few minutes here. Noticing the belly rise on the inhale and soften on the exhale. So we're about halfway through this resting pose now. Feel free to stay here for as long as you like. Just taking the opportunity to enjoy these quiet moments that we don't often get in our busy days. And I'll leave you here. Thank you for practicing with me today. I hope you have a lovely sleep. And I hope you join me for our next class next week. Thank you.